So UCLA finishes off the bars routine with nine nines from Merrill and Faehn back-to-back, while Cal ends their vault routines with 9-6-5 and 9-7-5 from McLeod and Smyth. And now the two teams will just switch places. The UCLA competitors will move over to the vault, and California, which is very strong in the bars, will move over there.
Yes, California is definitely stronger on bars than they are on vault. But we have UCLA going over to vault, which they say is their worst event. So we'll see what they can put together over there.
Up and down, roller coaster scoring for Cal on the uneven bars. Orsino, Shigioka, Kasuto, Goyer, Smyth, and Cindy Tom, who had that 10 last month in Seattle. For UCLA, and there you see a nice look of Valerie Kondos, the co-head coach for the vaulters of the Bruins. Megan Fenton, Holly Bremer, Thorne, Faehn, Nelson, and Merrow. Again, Merrow is the person who has the best score heretofore for UCLA on the vault. There's a 3-minute period between rotations so that the teams can do some work, get warmed up, get ready to move on, because there are, of course, several competitors on each team who do the all-around, so they do every event, and of course there are some specialists as well. Nice look at Pam Burgess, who is here in her 7th season as the coach of California. She, before she took over as the head coach here, she was coaching several club teams. In fact, she founded a club team in Bozeman, Montana. She's one of the premier judges of competition in the United States, a brevet judge.
Well, it seems that there's a little bit of a discrepancy over on vaulting. You're not supposed to approach a judge on the floor, and it seems that one of the coaches did so.
I think
from UCLA. It seems they were having a little discussion over that. It seems like everything's pretty much worked out right now.
Controversy already.
It's always there in this sport.
We'll have to send our Inside Edition reporter down there and find out what's going on. So now the UCLA vaulters move in, and this is Megan Fenton.
And Megan performed the layout souk, had a little trouble on the landing. In the air, her body is supposed to be totally straight, and it was a little bit pike. So there'll be a small deduction for that, but all in all, it was a pretty good vault. You can see her body's a little bit piked in the air, whereas it's supposed to be completely straight. But that's up to the judges how much to deduct for that. Again, you can see the body pike just a little bit.
And a 9.3 on that first effort by Fenton, who this year has gone and done a 9.4. She's a 5-foot freshman out of Utah. She also competed just a bit ago in the bars, in which she did a 9.7.
Hopefully we'll get to see the same vault, but in a completely straight body position this time. It was a little better, but the landing was actually a little lower. Because her body was completely laid out that time, her rotation was slowed down, so the landing was a little bit lower. You're a straight body position for much longer than the time before, but then the landing's a little bit lower.
So now we move to California on the uneven parallel bars. Samantha Orsino.
Watching Samantha in warm-up, she had a little trouble with her form, so we'll see if she can keep her legs together on most of her trips this time. There, you saw her legs split a little bit there.
It would be a trick if I did this. It's a routine if you do it. That's not very amusing at this point.
No,
after she falls.
I'm sure she's not too happy about that. That's a different release move than you've seen previously. This is called a delcheb, where she swings up, does a half turn, and then a front flip. And she's supposed to catch the bar, but she's a little bit closer. You see her hands bounce off the bar, and she just can't grab onto it after that.
This is kind of nasty on your wrists, isn't it?
Yep, this sport can be nasty on a lot of your body. Let's see if she can keep this routine going now. She knows she had a fall. She'll have to regain her composure and finish with a nice fist mount here. And a laid out culminates fist mount. It was a nice finish for her. It was too bad she couldn't hold on that one release move.
So we've seen each of the teams now have one of their competitors fall during the bars routine. Thorne did it for UCLA.
That's another layout to Sugihara. Again, a little bit piked in her hips, but it was better than her teammates was.
After Fenton's 9-3 on the vault, Holly Bremer now takes over here.
Your body position is much straighter, but right at the end she pikes down. And I'm sure she knows that, and I'm sure she's going to try and keep it straight. It's a little bit difficult because if you feel like you're flipping slow, you want to pike down naturally in order to land on your feet.
These competitors generally will do the same routine twice?
Sometimes they do the same vault twice, or they can choose to do a different vault on the second vault. It just depends. Sometimes it's easier to do the same vault twice, so you can improve on what you did the time before.
A 9.45 on that first effort by Bremer.
Well, her vault was actually a little bit higher, but she piked down a little bit more, causing her to step back because she had too much rotation. You'll see her body position straight, and then she pikes a little bit too much, which causes her to have that step.
After Samantha Orsino's 9.0 routine on the bars, here's 18-year-old freshman Cassie Shigioka from Escondido, California, to do her routine for California. She has gone 9.55 in this event this year.
And Cassie had a nice combination there. She did a giant blind half turn to a front giant. She kept her form very good on front giants. That's difficult to do. Winding up for her dismount. Double tuck flyaway. A little bit low, which caused her to take that step. But all in all, she did a nice routine.
Her teammates are certainly delighted by the performance.
Definitely happy. They know they had one fall already, so they don't want to have another one. Comes her dismount, a little short of the rotation, but she's able to save it with just one step forward.
Amy Thorne is
and Amy does
one
of those
here.
One of those twisting vaults which you saw many of the Cal gymnasts do, and she also has trouble with the landings. They're very difficult because they're just twisting until they hit. And sometimes you don't quite know where you are until your feet do hit, and that's too late to save a landing. There goes her trouble with her landing. She's just a little bit too much rotation.
So it's been a tough time here in two events so far for Thorne. Struggled on her bars routine. She has another opportunity here, though, in the vault.
Yes, and I'm sure she knows that. She's going to try and get a little bit more repulsion and not as much rotation this time.
On the first effort.
Better landing this time. She only has one step out of it. And her form was very good in the air. She twisted with her feet pretty close together. Here you can see her feet pretty good together, which is difficult to do, and just one step on the landing. She should be pretty happy with that vault.